Hello, we are discussing mathematical tool before watching this part 8 and this lecture product of vectors. Product of vectors. So there are product of two vectors and three vectors. All these things are there, but we have to learn here product of two vectors only. So we have to learn product of two vectors. There are two type of product. Product of vectors, there are two type of product. One is a scalar product, another is vector product. So a scalar product and vector product, there are two type of product. One is a scalar product, say a scalar product, another is called vector product. Okay, so a scalar product and vector product. There are two vectors A and B. One of them, their product can be defined in a scalar product and vector product. A scalar product is a product in which vectors can be defined in a scalar product and vector product. So two vector, then A dot B is defined. This is also called dot product and cross product, right now. So this is called dot product. A dot B is called dot product. Called dot product. And vector product is also called cross product. Cross product. Why this is dot and cross product and why they are said to be scalar and vector product respectively, that we will discuss one by one. So dot product is a scalar product, cross product is a vector product. If let us discuss one by one. If A and B are any two vectors, a scalar product. Let me discuss here one by one. If A and B be any two vectors, then a scalar product is defined as A dot B, that is dot, which is equal to modulus of A, modulus of B and cos theta. Modulus is a scalar quantity, modulus of B is a scalar quantity and cos theta is also a scalar quantity because their output is a scalar quantity and therefore it is called a scalar product. Dot product is called a scalar product because output is a scalar quantity. So this is nothing else but A dot B, that is AB cos theta. This is what we will obtain. Modulus of A, modulus of B, that is AB cos theta. This is what will come in dot product. In cross product is defined as cross product is defined as if A and B be any two vectors, then cross product of A and B is defined as A cross B is equal to modulus of A, modulus of B into sine theta unit vector n. Because this one is a scalar, so all these three are a scalar quantity, but because multiply by vector, so it is a scalar multiple of vector, and a scalar multiple of vector is a vector quantity. So that is why it is also called, because output is a vector quantity, so it is called vector product. What is theta? Theta is angle between A and B, where theta is an angle between vector A and vector B. Between vector A and B, vector B. Right? So cross product is nothing else but A cross B is What? A cross B is, A cross B is nothing else but AB sine theta unit vector n. And what is this n? N is a unit vector normal to the plane of A cross B. So let us end n is unit vector plane of to the plane of A cross B. A cross B. Right? So how to find this direction? This will give the direction of this vector quantity. So it is a vector quantity. Right now, this is a vector quantity, right? And this one is an scalar quantity. This one is a scalar quantity. This is nothing else but a scalar quantity. So it is a scalar quantity, and this one is vector quantity. I hope you got this. Now, the vectors are like this. A and B are vectors and defined as A and B are two vectors. So let us draw this diagram here. Consider, and this is a vector B. Now this is a vector A and this is a vector B. Now A geometrical meaning of A cross B will be obtained by me is what? In only one diagram, I am going to discuss this. See, this is a, using parallelogram law, I am making this. Say, this is a parallelogram, right? I am using parallelogram and make this. This is a what? Make A and B. So, if we draw a perpendicular from here, this, then what will happen? If I draw a perpendicular, then what will happen? Right? If I draw a perpendicular, this is vector AB. Then what will happen? This will be, say, this is OABCD. Then if you draw a perpendicular from it here only, then AB is equal to, by geometry, and we have as result AD is equal to, what is this? AD is equal to mod of A and sine theta. We had did it earlier, and OD is equal to mod of A cos theta. So geometrical meaning of dot product, N is unit vector normal to the plane. So N is unit vector normal to this plane, right? So this is a n unit vector, n is here. Okay, so geometrical meaning of dot product, let me write here geometrical meaning of dot product, right? Geometrical meaning of dot product, what is that? A dot B is equal to mod of A, mod of B and cos theta. So that can be written as mod of A cos theta. This is mod of A cos theta is nothing else but projection of A on B. OD is what? Projection of A on OD is nothing else. That is projection of A on B. This is also called projection of vector A on vector B. Projection vector A on B is mod of A cos theta. So we can write here this modulus of B into modulus of A cos theta. And modulus of A cos theta is projection of vector A on B multiplied by magnitude of B. So it can be defined as A dot B is defined as projection of product of magnitude of vector B, magnitude of vector B, right now, and projection of A projection of vector A on B on vector B in direction of B. Direction of vector B. So this is the geometrical meaning of dot product. A dot B means projection of B on projection, magnitude of B and projection of A on B. Similarly, we can also define, if you draw perpendicular from B to A, then we can define it as product of magnitude of A and projection of B on A. So same thing, you can do it. But what about this N? Here, this N is normal to this whole plane. This whole plane, this is a plane, A cross B. And N is unit vector, which will symbolically represent the product of A, the normal to any point of this vector, on this vector, you know. So that will be normal to any point on this vector. So we can do this. I hope you got this. N is unit vector normal to the plane, and the geometrical meaning of this. So wherever, if someone has to find projection of A on B, then what they will do? So to find projection of vector A on vector B can be defined as A dot B divided by modulus of B. Right, now projection, remember this. This is a very important one. It can be remembered. Important. Right, now projection of A on B. Similarly, we can write projection of, if someone has to write projection of B on vector A is defined as A dot B upon mod of A. Jiska, jis par projection nikalna hai, usi ke modulus se divide karenge. So this is also important. Right now, so make it this projection of A on B. So this is what. Now some applications. Applications. And what are these applications? We know for dot product, let me write here. A dot B, first of all, I dot I is equal to, what will happen? Mod of I, as per definition, I and I both are along x-axis, so angle between them is 0. So cos 0 is 1, and because these are unit vectors, so 1 into 1 into 1 is equal to 1. So I dot I is 1. So we can memorize this, I dot I. Similarly, j dot j is also 1, and k dot k is also 1. So this is one important thing that we need to learn. Second thing is that, second is a dot a is what? A dot a, second one is, we can write I dot j, then we will go for a dot. I dot j is equal to mod of j, and I and j are representing along x-axis and y-axis. So angle between and cos 90 is 0, so this is 0. So if you have I, j and k, three mutually perpendicular axis, right? And we have I into I, that will represent x-axis. This is x-axis, this is y-axis, and this is z-axis. So it is I, both I are along x-axis, j is along y-axis, and k is along z-axis. So between I and j, there is an angle 90 degree. So I dot I is equal to j is equal to k dot k is 1. But here, remember this second one, that is I dot j dot k dot I, it all is equal to 0, because the angle between them is 90 degree. Now the third point is mod of A into cos 0 degree. So this is A, mod of A into mod of A into 1, that is mod of A whole square. So we can write it mod of A whole square. A dot A is A square. This can be written simply as A square. There is no problem. Also, there are some other characteristics which is useful. A dot B is equal to B dot A, because these are a scalar quantity. So we can do it. right now. There is no 2 into 3 and 3 into 2 are the same thing. The fifth property is that we can learn as A dot B plus C can be written as A dot B plus A dot C, because it's distributed law. This is called distributed law, and this one is called commutative law. Commutative law holds, right now, and this one is called distributive law. Distributive law. This also holds, right now. A dot B plus C. If A dot B is equal to 0, if A dot B is equal to 0, this implies either vector A is itself 0 or B is equal to 0 or A is perpendicular to B. Seventh one, if vector A is perpendicular to vector B, this implies A dot B definitely equal to 0. So you can do this all properties and memorize this. There is another property which can be used here. Mod of A plus B whole square is equal to mod of A square plus mod of B square plus 2 times of A dot B. Similarly, if you have A minus B, then you can go ahead with this formula as well. So these are few questions and few formulas that you should learn it. Now, if A, remember this, if A is equal to A1i plus A3k and B is equal to B is a vector which is described as B1i plus B2j plus B3k, then A dot B is equal to, then A dot B is equal to A1b1 plus A2b3b3. Remember this, this is very important, you know, important. Right, because A dot I dot I will be 1, I dot J will be 0, I dot K will be 0, J dot I will be 0, J dot J will be 1, so A2B2 will be obtained, and J dot K will be 0, K dot I is 0, K dot J is 0, and K dot K is 1, so A3B3 will be obtained. So this is a very important one, and you must memorize this. So this one is one formula which you need to learn, right? Now, what about the cross product? So let us discuss some more about the cross product. In properties of cross product, so properties of cross product, right? So here, I cross I is what? I cross I is mod of I and sine 0. Sine 0 is 0. So that will be 0. So I cross I is 0. So one thing which you will remember, that I cross I is 0. J cross J is also 0. K cross K is also, I cross J is equal to K. Remember, this is a cyclic one. Alright now. So remember this cycle. And on the basis of this cyclic, you will calculate this. I cross J is equal to K. And J cross K I is equal to opposite to that. So according to right hand screw system rule, J cross I is minus J cross I is minus K. Right now? And remember, this is an I, J and K, right? So I cross J, K. J cross K is I. J cross K is I. Got it? Now, so K cross I, this is anti-clockwise, K cross I, clockwise, and clockwise, what will happen? K cross J is equal to minus I. Similarly, if I'll write here few more things, that is K cross I, and if there is an I cross K, then it will be minus J. So these are few points which you need to learn, right now. And it is right handed screw system, that is unit vector perpendicular to both the planes. So if I have this x axis and y axis, then z axis is perpendicular to it. right? So ZX is nothing else, but this will be perpendicular to it. So I cross J equal to K. And if there is X axis, Y axis, and it is sweep like this, then the angle thumb will represent the Z axis direction. If I make this as like this, I cross J. This is the vector I, right now. And this is the J. If I sweep, then thumb will represent the cross product of these two. So that is vector K. And if I have this I cross J again, and if I represent, then thumb will represent this direction. So I cross J and J cross I. So direction will be given by thumb rule, right hand thumb rule. So it is given the direction, right now. So I cross J is K, and K cross I is, this is J and this is K. K is mutually perpendicular to this plane. So I cross J is, if we start from I and go towards J, start from I and go towards J, then what will be the thumb impression? That is K, J, and go towards I. But some more characteristics like third one, A cross B. So here are some formula. A cross B is equal to, formula is there, that if A cross B is equal to 0, if A cross B is equal to 0, this employee either is equal to 0, or vector B is equal to 0, or A is parallel to vector B. Fifth one is, if A is parallel to vector B, then A cross B will be definitely equal to 0. A is parallel to B, then A cross B will be definitely equal to 0. If A is parallel to B, this employee A cross B must be equal to 0. Right? And two vectors are parallel if, since that is very important, if A is equal to, remember this, A1i plus A2j plus A3k, and B vector is equal to B1i plus B2j plus B3k, then A cross B can be obtained as by using this formula, determinant of ijk, right here, A1, A2, A3, B1, B2, B3. And now if you calculate it like this, you have this, how to calculate. If you write here I, then you need to cancel this row and this column. Then what will be left? That multiply with this minus this, that you need to calculate. So it will be A2, B3 minus B2, A3. Right? Then you have to put negative sign. This is a determinant, you will study this in class 12, but here I am just telling you application. So this cancel. Now again, these two and these two are left. So multiply in the same way, A1, B3 minus B1, A3. Right now? And then there is K plus minus plus. This is the way. And K lies in each, this row and this column, so you need to cancel them. If you cancel them, this one and this one, these four are left. Again, multiply in the same manner. So that will be A1, B2 minus A2, B1. So this is the way in which we can find the cross multiplication of two vectors. You can go ahead with that method also, where I cross J is equal to K, you write it. But this is an easier method, and so I advise you to go for determinant method only, right now, and that will be A cross B. Let me explain with one example in which you can do it. A vector is 2i plus j plus k, right, and B vector is I plus 2j minus k, like this. Find A cross B, vector A cross B, right now, we have to find. So we can write here this concept. A cross B is equal to, what we write here, this is I, J and K, and the value of coefficients are 2, 1, 1, here is coefficient of iota is 1, J coefficient is 2, and K coefficient is minus. Now you have to calculate with this method. What will happen? This cancel, this cancel. This is minus 1, minus 2. Minus 1, minus 2. Product of these two. Remember this? What is this? Product of these two minus product of this two. So it will be what? That will be, remember this, minus 1 and minus sign you have to put in between. Minus 2. So minus 1, minus 2. Again, like minus j. And j is cancelled. This cancel, this cancel. So this product is minus 2 and minus 1. So minus 2, minus 1. And plus k into. Again, plus k into. What is that? This cancel, this cancel. 2 to j, 4 minus 1. So what will be the output? Output is, this is minus 3i. And this is minus 3 multiplied by minus h plus 3j. And 4 minus 1, that is 3. So 3k. This is a cross product of A plus B. So this is the solution you have. So I can say that whenever you practice them, definitely you will be able to get it. Discuss some more questions and some more concepts as well. So angle between two vectors. This is angle between two vectors. Two vectors. Right? So if A and B be any two vectors, if A and B be any two vectors, then angle between A and B, angle between A and B, vector A and vector B is given by cos theta is equal to A dot B upon mod of A mod of B. This is a formula. So there is a question. If I'll write a question, find the angle between in vectors A, say 3i plus 2j minus k and 2i minus 2j minus 2k. Right, find the angle between these two vectors. Let first one is described as vector A and second one is described as vector B. So let A is 3i and B is nothing else but 2i minus 2j minus 2k, say like this. So if I have to find out, therefore angle between them is given by by cos theta is equal to what we have learned formula, A dot B upon mod of A mod of B, right? So first of all, we will find modulus of these two vectors, right? Or A dot B. So A dot B will be given by, as we have learned the formula, 3 into A1 A2 plus B1 B2 plus C1 C2. So 3 into 2 plus 2 into minus 2 plus minus 1 into minus 2. So what is that? That will be 3 to the 6 minus 4 and this is minus 2. Say this is a, let me write here, check it, plus 2. Right here, plus 2. So that will be, this will be B is plus 2. I want to make it 0. So that will be here also. If it was plus 2, then that will be plus 2. Right now? So 2, it will be 2 here also. 2. And therefore 4 minus 2, which is equal to 0. Since A dot B is equal to 0, and therefore angle between them is 90 degrees. And therefore vector A is perpendicular to vector B, and hence angle between them is 90 degrees. Between them is 90 degrees. Here one more question, and question is find the angle between vectors I plus j minus k and I minus j plus k equal to, let A is equal to I plus j minus k and I minus j plus k, right? And now A dot B is equal to, by using this formula we have to apply, I dot I is 1, so 1 into 1 plus j is 1, and here j coefficient of j is minus 1, here coefficient of k is minus 1, and here coefficient of k is 1. So that is 1 minus 1 minus 1, it's minus 1. So A dot B is nothing else but minus 1. Now modulus of A and modulus of B has to be calculated. Now we can calculate mod of A. Mod of A is coefficient of I square, that is 1 square, plus coefficient of j square, that is 1 square, plus coefficient of k square, that is minus 1 square. So that will be 1 plus 1 is root 3. Mod of B also equal to, that is coefficient of I square, that is 1 square, square, that is coefficient of j square, which is minus 1 square, plus coefficient of k square, that is 1 square, which is also equal to 1 plus 1 plus 1, that is root 3. Now cos theta is given as we have formula like cos theta is given as A dot B divided by modulus of A and modulus of B. So that will come here, cos theta is equal to minus 1 upon root 3 into root 3, that is theta is equal to cos inverse minus 1 by 3. That will be answer, right? This will be answer. You need to write in this way only, no need to write exact value because you don't know. You don't know exact value, so you no need to write exact value, okay? I hope you got it, the basic knowledge about the vector algebra, and the questions related to vector in physics will be discussed in more, while we will discuss motion in plane. So related questions and expected questions on complete application test will be discussed during the teaching of the topic. Here is just basic knowledge because we are not teaching here vector algebra, but the tool which is will be useful. So the important formula and important concepts have been discussed here, and the problems will be discussed while discussing dimension and or motion in plane or any other questions where boat problem, river boat problem, rain and motion problem, like all these problems we will discuss, and we will use this vector. Thereafter vector will be used in rotational dynamics as well. Everywhere vector will be used. So corresponding questions of each chapter will be related to vector will be discussed accordingly. Till then, God bless you, keep watching, and take care of